Gentlemen's Club at the Lawn Tennis Association heralds the first day of Wimbledon. Although 6 hours before the gates will be opened, the head of the queue has already formed, soon to be joined by enthusiasts from far and wide. Printed overnight and carried them up to the drawer that decides the order of play. Last minute instructions, though many are familiar with the job, are given to those who will ensure the smooth direction of the crowd. But they have noses to help them. Might have known I couldn't read, and after cue that must cope with a sudden inrush of up to 30,000 people into a comparatively small area. However, if any are confused, there to help, as always, are members of the WVS, the St. John's Ambulance Brigade, and the men of the British Legion, who just before the gates are opened, go to take up their positions. Twelve o'clock. The signal is given to open the gate. The 70th Wimbledon has begun, and the rush for the best places is on. Nervousness at 2 o'clock and the start of play approaches. The time has come, and on walks the holder of the men's singles title, Nick Faisher. It is the holder who traditionally plays the first match on the center court. With him is the player who has had the perhaps unfortunate honor of having drawn so formidable an opponent. So too on the outer court. The first point has been played, and Wimbledon is fully underway. Alongside the centre court, or number one court, Billy Knight, the British junior champion, showed his fine fighting spirit against the stronger Ulrich of Denmark, who won after five grueling sets. Meanwhile, on the center court, Faisher had summarily dismissed his first challenger. And so the first week of